The next topic which we are going to study today is corrosion. Corrosion. But what is corrosion? Let's have brainstorming over corrosion. Let's have brainstorming upon corrosion. Corrosion means rusting. Corrosion takes place due to presence of oxygen, moisture, and vapors of chemicals present in air. My dear student, rusting of iron is an example of corrosion. Corrosion takes place because of the presence of oxygen, moisture, and vapors of chemical present in the air. Corrosion of metal takes place, and in corrosion of metals, following things takes place. For example, the corrosion of metal involves what happens whenever there is corrosion of metal. First thing, formation of reddish brown layer. In corrosion of iron, there is formation of reddish brown layer on iron particles. In the corrosion of copper, there is formation of greenish layer on copper particles. Due to which, we can say that there is corrosion taking place in iron and copper. But what happens when there is corrosion in metals? Whenever there is corrosion in metals, the metals become weak. The metal becomes weak. My dear student, from this brainstorming, we have understood that whenever metals such as iron and copper come in contact with oxygen, moisture and vapors of chemical in air, corrosion takes place. Whenever the corrosion takes place, then formation of reddish brown layer takes place on iron particles. In the same way, formation of greenish layer takes place on copper particles. And whenever there is formation of reddish brown layer on iron particles and greenish layer on copper particles, we can say there is corrosion of iron and corrosion of copper. Now, my dear student, there is disadvantage of corrosion. That is that whenever corrosion takes place, the metal becomes weak. So, in order to avoid corrosion of metal, we can avoid metals coming in contact with air, oxygen, moisture and chemicals present in the air. This we can do with the help of certain processes which are given in our book, and they are galvanization is a process with which we can avoid corrosion in metal. In the process of galvanization, we do not allow the metal to come in contact with oxygen, moisture and chemicals present in the air. In the same way, another method which is given in the book, which can help us to avoid corrosion, is pinning. In this method also, the metals are not allowed to come in contact with oxygen, moisture and vapors of chemical present in the air. And there is one more method given in the book in which we can avoid corrosion by not allowing the metal to come in contact with oxygen, moisture and chemical presence in the air is powder coating. Let's study this process one by one according to the definition which is given in our book. Galvanization. Galvanization. The process in which a thin layer of zinc is coated over iron articles to prevent them from corrosion is called as galvanization. My dear student, when we coat the iron articles with a thin layer of zinc metal, then this iron articles does not come in contact with oxygen, moisture and chemicals present in the air. And as the iron articles does not come in contact with oxygen, moisture and chemicals present in air, then corrosion of iron articles does not take place. Therefore, the process in which a thin layer of zinc is coated on iron article to prevent them from corrosion is called as galvanization. The another method which is given in our book to prevent corrosion of metal is tinning. But what is tinning? Let's first study the definition of tinning.
pinning.
My dear student, in the process of pinning, we do not allow the metal such as copper and bronze to come in contact with oxygen, moisture and chemicals in the air to avoid corrosion of copper and brass. Therefore, the process in which a thin layer of tin is coated on copper and brass articles to prevent them from corrosion is called as pinning. My dear student, in this both method, that is galvanization and tinning, we can avoid the corrosion of metal articles and copper and bronze articles by avoiding them in coming in contact with oxygen, moisture and chemicals present in the air. To avoid corrosion of iron articles, the iron articles are coated with zinc layer and it is called as galvanization. To avoid the corrosion of copper and brass, a thin layer of tin is coated on copper and brass to prevent them from corrosion, and the process is called as pinning. And the third method, which is given in our book to avoid corrosion of metal, is powder coating. And the third method, which is given in our book to avoid corrosion of metal, is powder coating. The process in which coats of various color are applied on metal such as iron and aluminium to prevent them from corrosion is called powder coating. That's all, student. We'll stop here.